regulators. We regulate any stealing of his property. We're damn good, too. But you can't be any geek off the street. Gotta be handy with the steel, if you know what I mean. Earn your keep.
Regulators! Mount up.
It was a clear black night, a clear white moon.
Yo, what is going down, everybody? And welcome to the All Seas Collectors Edition podcast. I'm your host. My name is James. To the left of me here is our DM, AJ.
Cheers.
Chris the Beard Packham.
Howdy.
And as always, KS Productions, Ken Sullivan behind the camera.
Yo.
Trish is going to miss this podcast this week. Going to do some books and accounting catch up instead. So we're going to keep rolling this machine along as we always do. Thank you for liking, following, being a part of this podcast every single month. For doing such, we like to give you something. And this month, what are we giving them, Ken?
I didn't bring that up here.
What oh, Ken didn't even bring it up here.
Oh, man.
He's running. He's going around the backside.
Every month we like to give you things, and this month we're giving you something, and last month we're giving you something.
So this month, in order to win, you need to like, comment, and share everywhere the podcasts are found. That there includes here on Facebook, over on Twitter, on YouTube, on iHeartRadio, on Podbean, on Apple iTunes, on Google Play. About a dozen chances every month to win. Ken's showing it off right now. You have your chance to win this Dungeons and Dragons figure. Who is that, Ken?
That's Holga.
Holga from the new movie.
Movie. And it's a really nice likeness. I mean, obviously the box art does it a lot better justice than the actual figure because they have to be simplified on there.
Fair enough.
Is this the 3 3/4 inch?
No, 6 inch.
Is it 6 inch?
Yep.
All right. 6 inch figure.
I was going to say that'd be a huge box for 3 3/4. But you know how they are with those products sometimes.
Box and plastic storage, they're going to use up whatever they can.
Absolutely. Yes.
Truth.
What up, fam? Says Facebook user.
Hey, what up? What up? Thanks for all being right with us.
Yo, yo, yo.
Some of you guys, it looks like you're maybe commenting from beyond the long box. There are other things. You need to go ahead and give it access to your Facebook account so it'll show us your name. Otherwise, all I see is Facebook user is talking at us.
That's all good, though. Thanks for being with us. And our sponsor, of course, A Mile High Card Company. A Mile High Card Company, the best card auction house in the game, located in Castle Pines, Colorado. The seller of the last known Honus Wagner to hit the market, A Mile High Card Company. Check them out.
That's who I want to see a Netflix show about.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. Matt Golden? Ken Golden? Mm-hmm. You're fancy?
Just saying, yeah.
But a great new collectible show real quick. We'll get into it at entertainment later on by Golden Auctions. Check it out on Netflix. We'll go over it, though, a little bit in entertainment.
All righty.
Metals? Is that what we're going to talk about?
I think we're in the markets. Where we at?
We got $20 down. Silver down, $24.35.
Under 25 again. I'm saying buy now, people.
Did they raise the debt ceiling this week already?
No, this shit's about to go down in a week if something doesn't go down.
So I think it's anticipation that they're going to raise the debt ceiling.
I'm looking up right now. They might have changed something today.
But yeah, that made it go down. Something might have happened or speculation of that happening. We'll see. We'll see. All right. What we don't need to see, and we know for a fact.
Nope, did not meet today. Nothing approved.
Yeah, they're still talking. What's a constant is Chris Packham and them picks from the beard. Let's hear them comic picks. Best in the game. He's excited as ever to tell you about it.
Oh, you know I am.
Yes.
Here we go. We got Silk number one. Silk's back in her another series. Always love the Silk series. Always a fun time.
Chris, did that one come out of your personal hold slot?
No,
it's going in mine.
It did not come out of my personal home slot this week.
I didn't grab that one yet.
Too bad. Too bad. You're missing out. Silk's always a fun read. Hopefully there's some Peter Parker in with that because it's always hilarious when those two get together because they can't keep their hands off each other.
Oh, Cindy Moon, one of my favorite characters in here that they've added in the last few years.
Yeah, something about because they got bit by the same, but they just got attracted to each other and just want to bang
literally
like rabbits.
Literally pheromone attraction.
I see, like spider instinct. Yeah,
they want to bang like rabbits when they're around.
Or spiders.
Yeah. Our spider.
Is she going to eat him, though? Is that same thing, though, at the end?
She has not yet. She has not yet.
Peter Parker.
Yeah.
Dead.
Turn villain.
Next up, we got Batman the White Knight. New miniseries. Gang of Jokers. Right?
Generation Joker.
I can't read.
Looks like a young Joker.
Should have been fun. I love the White Knight universe. It's always a fun read. You know, Batman being the bad guy, Joker being smart. You know, it's a fun, good time to have by all. And I can't wait to read this new miniseries.
Sounds like a generation of Jokers, Ken. Maybe multiple generations.
Because there's not enough books about giant apes. We got King Kong.
King Kong.
King Kong got a new miniseries from Dynamite Comics.
He's a badass.
It's King Kong, the Ape War. Is that the Ape War? Right?
The Great War.
The Great War. Hopefully he's going to explain something about what happened on Skull Island or the Middle Earth or whatever.
It's a Skull Island. Yeah.
All right, we got the Jurassic World dinosaurs there.
So,
both the T-Rexes.
I love a good story about a giant ape. So, you know, King Kong, awesome. Let's see what he's doing. Next up, because we don't have enough universes in the world, we have to go Venomverse. And
Venomverse,
what's Venomverse going to be? But extreme. What is it? Extreme Venomverse extreme. For you people out there who
Spider-Man 4 trailer that's circling around with the Sony Venom on the Tobey Maguire or what's the young kid right now?
Holland,
yeah, Tom Holland. And it like these fan made ones are looking badass. So
I just want to throw out that I've been waiting for Venomverse. I also about 3 years ago did Venomized covers, and all that came from a ditched project from back in like 2013. They were supposed to do is like, I think it was called Venomverse or something like that. But it was supposed to be all these people, Wolverine getting Venomized, Captain America getting Venomized. And so they scrapped the project, did Venomized covers a few years later, and now we're getting Venomverse. I've waited for this for almost 10 years now.
And we have Venomized Pops. We have Venomized.
Oh, yeah. I want Venom on everything. Any hero can be a Venom.
Hey, here's a little known fact.
About a good movie. A
little known fact about Kurt Bishop from Brandy Bishop. Thanks for watching, following us. He is from a Numbskull Island.
Kurt is from Numbskull Island. Speaking of this Numbskull.
Yes.
Hey, James, what's a tougher movement to pass? A
bell?
Chris Star or
a Cry Star or a Rock Lord?
Ooh. The kidney stone.
I say Crystar.
Crystar is going to make you cry.
Exactly.
Well, what we got next, Chris?
Next up, we got a fun book from DC. They're branching out to new group of characters featuring Asian superheroes. This one's called Spirit World. There's supposed to be three of these books coming out this week, each one featuring a different group of characters.
This week.
I don't even know what day it is anymore.
This one, pretty cool. It feels kind of like those of you who've seen Avatar The Last Airbender, like when they go into the spirit world and they're like dealing with ancestors of the past and these creatures and very much delving into that mythology.
Yeah, Spirit World, it looks really cool. The artwork on it's pretty good. I'm looking forward to reading it.
I guess. Not too bad. Is this a Peach Momoko story? Cover?
I'll give you guys all a preview. We're going to be getting City Boy coming up in the next couple weeks. We didn't order very heavy on it, but kind of a cool concept, the whole idea that the literal city, he could be in Gotham, he can be in Metropolis, wherever, the city talks to him, the city tells him its secrets. So if the city knows that you're Batman, he now knows that you're Batman.
I think it starts in Gotham City.
I think it does. The city and him are one and the same.
Yeah.
We got a question for Kurt. Hey, Kurt, which one were you passing when you were in the bathroom for an hour?
Was that the Cry Star or the Rock
Lord? I'm pretty sure that was the Rock Lord that he was passing.
It was an hour. I'm going to go Rock Lord. Sounds like a
number. All right. What are we ending it on here, Chris?
We're ending on what was supposed to be the most shocking events in Spider-Man in 40 years. Sorry. Actually, I think it might be close to 50 years. No, not really. Not if you've been reading the story. But it's Amazing Spider-Man 25 with an awesome throwback cover, Whatever Happened to Mary Jane. Now, if you've been reading the Spider-Man story, it's not really shocking. Wasn't bad. I kind of figured it was kind of cool. It sucks a little bit because they spent so long trying to get them back together, but she does not die. Spoiler alert. So
that's good. I didn't want her to die. Who doesn't like Mary Jane?
I would have been upset if they killed off Mary Jane. I'm not going to lie. That would have, you know.
It would have soured Chris's britches for a minute.
Yeah. Mm. I'd have been a little salty.
Kurt responds, stop it, Brandy.
Before we move on, that's a bunch of stuff came out this week. A lot of stuff. I think you guys will find something you want to like. But hey, thank you guys for coming out for Free Comic Book Day.
Yeah. Oh yes,
we appreciate you guys coming out, supporting us and your local comic book stores. Always a fun time to be had by all. I love it. One of the best days of the year. And if you know Marvel and Sony, I dropped the ball on Free Comic Book Day because read an article about it today. Thursday last week, they announced that hey, we're gonna do a Free Comic Book Day adaptation or story adaptation for the Spider-Man 2 video game. Nobody knew about it except for a few people because they left Diamond out of the loop. So basically, what sounded like they cut Diamond out entirely. Perfect. And it was Penguin and Sony who dropped the ball, not Diamond. And from what I understand, half the stores didn't get them. Some of the Penguin Direct stores got them. Some of them got like a few. Some of them got many.
Yeah, sell for $200.
So thank you, Marvel and Sony and Penguin and Sony for dropping the ball.
Dominic Pacheco was showing me at work the other day. Dom and I were looking. They're selling as high as $400.
Yeah, because not everybody got them. The article I read.
You know, it wasn't that much. It was a bundle for $400, so it was $20.
The article I read said that. That they dropped the ball that, like, wherever the guy was, he didn't say where it was, but in his area, out of the five stores in his area, only, like, three of them got it. One of them got, like, 20 copies. One of them got, like, 50 copies. And one of them got, like, 60 copies. But his store and somebody else didn't. And it sounded like it was just the Penguin Direct stores. And somebody was telling me earlier that it was pretty much just the East Coast stores that got them. Nobody on the West Coast or Midwest.
Sounds about right.
Got it. So Penguin and them dropped the ball on that. So
well, and I just want to piggyback on Free Comic Book Day, because you all tuned in last Thursday, you hadn't caught this yet. James, myself, Trish, we all were up at the Capitol, Ken in Darkwing Duck there on Friday last week, getting Colorado to recognize Free Comic Book Day as a state recognized holiday.
Thank you, Senator Tom Sullivan. Thanks, Colorado, the state Senate of Colorado.
Governor Polis, Tom Sullivan, great trip up there.
That was amazing. We also got Free Comic Book Day as a proclamation that it's going to be a holiday here in the state of Colorado. Free Comic Book Day, not just to come
going forward, but proclamation that Free Comic Book Day is celebrated in Colorado. She came out of nowhere. Trish just popping out those news.
Yes,
gotta love it.
True, I love it.
All right.
Thanks for joining.
Hey, James.
Hey, just always working.
Love the Warhammer 40K figures. Thank you, AJ Lowe. Oh, that wasn't a full thing. Hey. Anytime, Kurt, we're getting you some more Warhammer stuff. Come on in.
Right on. We're direct with Games Workshop now.
We're getting that. We're putting that word together.
Getting it done. That's what we do. Also, we got big gaming releases. Was that it, Chris, at all?
That was a big on entertainment news, yeah.
Okay. All right. Gaming releases this week. AJ, what you got?
March of the Machine Aftermath. This is a big set they're releasing. It is an experimental set. This is they're calling it a prologue set. It is the cards they couldn't fit into the first set that are telling the story, but they're just cutting to the good stuff. There is no commons in this set. There are a handful of uncommons. They're rares and they're mythics. So we got two types of boosters. You got your collector boosters, the always great. It'll have a few foil uncommons, nothing but foils. Foil uncommons, mythics, and rares. Beyond that, you are also going to have your epilogue boosters. It is a new thing they're trying for these prologue series where they are just doing a smaller run. And what they're going to do with the epilogue boosters is it is a 5-card booster. That booster can have 1 to 4 uncommons in it, and 1 to 3 uncommons, 1 to 4 uncommons, and 2 to 3 rares. So the way you will hit it is you can have up to 3 rares in it. The rest will be uncommons. So it's 2 to 4 uncommons, 1 to 3 rares. So it could be 2 uncommons, 3 rares. It could be 4 uncommons, 1 rare, mythics included in the rare spots. It is going to be a smaller price point than your normal packs. I think they're going back down to about $350. I have to double check that individual price point on those packs for the epilogue booster. But then the individual collector boosters are going to be staying right around collector booster price on those. And that's going to take us right into next month with that Lord of the Rings set we already talked about before. It's going to be a higher price point. It's being treated as a master set at the new master set price point. And it's limited. People are going to be flying all over it. So I'm telling you guys, if you aren't in line day one on that set, you're too late.
Fair enough. It's true that.
Brandy says, is Kurt banned from the store for wearing his socks with his flip-flops into the store?
No, it was just a strike.
No, I mean, no. Kurt's never banned. We love Kurt. He's a great customer. He always has been. Great enthusiasm. I love Kurt's collectible enthusiasm and his knowledge and his collection. It's quite massive. A little odd with the socks and flip-flops.
I will say that.
Maybe he's scared. Maybe he's got a little fungi on them. Big toe. You know what I mean?
Here's what I got to say.
Hide it, Brandy. You don't want everyone to see that.
Brandy, if you could please, going into next Free Comic Book Day, make sure Kurt washes his Superman outfit so he can wear it. He's complaining that it stinks too much to come down here. We expect Kurt to be our Superman.
Yeah.
We miss Superman.
People are quite heartbroken about that. What I'm heartbroken is sports card releases didn't have any this week, really. Nothing major came out at all. We do have a big restock of basketball going on. Playoffs full swing. We'll cover that in sports news. But, you know, let's go Nuggets. All right. Let's go to buys of the week. Buys of the week. We had some buys, great buys this week.
Kurt is headed our way. Brandy banned him from the house.
Damn. Put them flip-flops and socks in the house. All right.
He can get some Warhammer paint.
Here's a great pull out of Leaf Multigraph. This is a hexagon autograph. And it's Hakeem Olajuwon, best center of all time. Patrick Ewing right there. Shaquille O'Neal, one of the best centers of all time. Dikembe Mutombo.
Is that six autos?
That's Robert Parrish, the big chief. What's up about the big chief? And then we got Ralph Sampson. Six autos.
Double-sided.
One guy doesn't belong on there.
101.
But Ralph Sampson wasn't a bad player.
Was he a center, Ralph Sampson?
He was a forward slash center.
He must have played five. So yeah. Four or five. But sweet card. Leaf makes the best autograph cards that actually you can pull in the game. Pay a little higher price for them, but you get something out of them. Next up,
this is hot.
Second pick in the draft of the NHL last year. That's Quentin Byfield. Quentin Byfield, that auto patch rookie at SP Game Used Hockey. Upper Deck making the cleanest, prettiest card there is in the game. I love that patch and that piece.
Really hard to show it off. It's so nice.
Autograph on card.
Low number, 39 out of 100.
Huge pick. Beautiful great piece. Hockey fantasy pick.
Great, great card.
What else we got here?
Chris, what do we got for them comic book buys?
We have...
Caliber Presents.
The Caliber Presents, is that number 15? Number
what?
One.
What?
Number one.
I was going to say number one. Caliber Presents number one.
Caliber Presents number one. The first appearance of James O'Barr's The Crow. Mm-hmm. Now, it's a good book. I love that. It's a really nice book. Hard to come by. You don't see it very often. You know what today is, Chris? Today happens to be the anniversary of the release date of The Crow. Starring 29 years ago,
the theatrical release of The Crow.
And one of the first non-Star Wars movies I saw that somebody cosplayed as.
Still the best comic book movie made of all time, I'm going to say.
It's a great comic book movie. Blade
is a great comic movie, too.
Speaking of The Crow.
There's Crow number one right there.
Crow number one.
Comics and James O'Barr. It's Eric Draven on the cover.
I love this. It's a great series. His artwork is underrated. Oh, James O'Barr.
It is, especially on The Crow. It's really, really good. The darkness of The Crow comes through. It's black and white comic.
I'm pretty sure when he wrote it, he didn't think it was going to get as popular as it did.
Right, he didn't. I think he sold that for pennies on the dollar.
Yeah, because he just basically the project was the way was to heal himself or whatever. So
it's a great story.
It is a great story.
Absolutely. Here's another fun one that came in from our man Ken over here. He brought us a copy of NES TMNT number one, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the self-titled game, signed by Kevin Eastman. $100 over at the Gaming Arena. We'll be bringing that to TCG Con next weekend if you guys are there.
Yeah, boy.
That's a great piece.
Beautiful item. One of the first NES games I ever played.
Kevin Eastman, great guy to meet if you ever meet him.
Amazing guy.
Yep.
And Kurt, you are correct that the Crow soundtrack is one of the best.
It is amazing. Pantera, as we're talking Nine Inch Nails
about the Crow's release, I just got to say, I recently learned, and I'm just saying, I'm disappointed in my dad. My dad, all my life raising me to watch The Next Generation, never informed me. Next Generation came out on my birthday. September 28th, 1987 was the first two episodes of Next Generation.
Oh, yeah.
Boom. And AJ.
That makes
sense. Wow, that makes a lot of sense.
If you watched Encounter at Farpoint, you wouldn't want to brag that it came out the same day.
Hey, listen, we don't talk about the first season of Next Generation, but everything after that.
This is true. This is true. It was nothing good that was in the, except for the Ferengi. The Ferengi were the best part.
Much like me, was still in its infancy.
Yes.
Laws of acquisition.
The laws of acquisition.
The Ferengi coming in, what, episode four there, maybe?
Yeah, yeah.
Of course, they changed the Ferengi over the years because the Ferengi in the first...
The true capitalists.
They were true capitalists, and they had some great lines in the first season that as the show went on and it expanded into DS9, the Ferengi weren't like they were in the first season.
No, I know, but Quark's still great.
Quark is awesome. So Rom, Nog, I loved all those guys. Grand Nagus, his mom...
As Trish is busy working again on that accounting, that job never stops, and that always working here at Allseas, always busy with things. We're going to do show and tell.
Whew. Keeping on a theme, I feel like.
Why don't you sing it still, Ken?
Not the same. No. She's not here.
James is show and tell.
Call it the same.
Here we go.
We got the Crow, one scale Mezco figure to celebrate the Crow today in the 29th anniversary.
My boy Eric Draven there.
On this rainy day.
Brandon Lee.
Coming out of nowhere.
How about the Crow Mezco? Do you approve?
I did, and I actually showed that off several weeks ago.
Well, it's the anniversary.
We had to re-show it off. It's the Crow anniversary. We're talking up our boy Eric Draven today.
Did you show
today.
That Crow figure off?
Brandon Lee.
She heard the very sad James's show and tell. She had to come out to see what this was all about.
That's Mezco House. We have another Crow figure by Brandon Lee. and the crow. It's a Mezco. What scale is
this? This is the 5 points.
5 points articulation.
It's 3 3/4.
3 3/4. No, but it looks awesome. It's a great figure. I want to kind of get that figure, actually. I bet that box doesn't know justice.
It's two figure sets, actually. It's two figures.
Two figure sets. You're listening to this on the podcast. Two figures, one box.
$40.
Great piece. Then we got another great release this week. The Book of Boba Fett Starship, known as the Great Slave 1. They can't call it Slave 1.
The Vintage Collection.
You know why they can't call it Slave 1 anymore?
It's wrong to say the word slave.
It's wrong to say the word slave.
I guess so. Even in the Star Wars universe.
No, that's legit.
Yeah.
Even comes with an old bald Boba Fett.
Ship. George Lucas did.
And honestly, some writer did, because the ship's never actually named in any Star Wars movie or whatever. They never say it's Boba Fett and Slave 1.
It was first named in one of the random-ass novels.
Yeah, it was just up there. They didn't have a name. I think the toy company made it, because when Empire Strikes Back came back, it was Slave 1.
You're going to put that on Kenner?
Yes.
All right, fair enough.
All your fault.
This is actually the second
piece right here.
Yeah, this is the second release of the retro packaging. What is the difference on this between the last time? Because they did a retro packaging and it was still called the Slave 1.
They took the name off.
They took the name off and re-released it. Old school Boba Fett.
It's coming with your Book of Boba Fett.
And it doesn't come with a Han and Carbonite.
So it's a fat Book of Boba Fett.
Yep.
All right.
Do we get a Finnegan? Boba Fett with we don't get a Finnegan, but she's in the.
It's fat Boba Fett, bald Boba Fett with a cloak.
Yeah.
It looks like. It's a lame.
It's that Boba first Fett episode Tatooine. Boba Fett on Tatooine.
It's like the least cool Boba Fett figure.
I didn't say
that. Yay! Buy it at All Seas Collectibles. It's fantastic.
But the ship's cool.
It's cool.
Is that the only way you can get that figure, though?
Probably. Kurt Bishop wants to know if you know that they are re-releasing the old Necco Gremlins.
Oh yeah, we've been getting them. Yes.
Boom! There's the answer.
Yeah, Chris Bishop, has been finding
where
them.
You been at?
Yeah, Chris Packham's been finding them.
Actually, at our Fan Expo, I was able to get my paws on, thanks to one of our good friends, Charo. Get my paws on the re-release of the Spider Gremlin. Yes. I know I got to boil down his legs so that way I can put it together. It was a re-release.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is. There's some differences. It's the coloring. The scale is exactly the same. You still got to boil the legs to put them on, and once you put them on, you're never getting them off, kind of thing.
Right.
If you do, get them in, you're the right not getting colors. Them back on again. Right, but right.
That's
yeah,
all right though.
That was a re-release, and that's,
toys are ready to be opened.
They are. They're going to re-release the bat as well, which I need to get my paws on when that comes out. But I imagine that's going to be kind of
the. I saw today or this morning that the Tattoo Gremlin 2-pack is starting to release.
Mm. Ooh. Ooh. We should get that in all season anytime.
Don't think I have the tattoo one.
I'm gonna be working.
It's cool because it has
Charo in August.
It has one tattoo with a big Gremlin with a big old WB tattoo on it, and the and the other guy looks like the guy who was reviewing it kept saying he looked like Rob Halford. It's a Rob Halford Gremlin because he came with the little biker vest and the hat and everything, and it looks really cool. I can't wait to see it in person.
Yeah, no. Can't wait. Yes, yes, indeed.
I was just the frog.
All right,
the Michigan J Frog.
Sports news, NBA playoffs full and swing, getting ready for the Western Conference Finals and then Eastern Conference Finals, getting ready to crown that NBA championship in about a month.
Who would have guessed all this stuff being 3-2?
Let's go. Nuggets leading the series, playing tonight.
Right, you're up
3-2 against the Suns, starting at 8 o'clock tip-off.
Come on.
Right now, 76ers versus the Celtics is on right now.
I knew there was a game going.
76ers are up in that series 3-2. Lakers up in their series against Golden State 3-2. And Miami, surprising everybody, up 3-2 in their series. NFL draft schedule was announced today. And the Broncos schedule is out. They got the Raiders. Ooh. Raiders week one, though.
Raiders week one, what? Chiefs week. Week off, Chiefs again, and then bye week for them, if I got that schedule right there.
I got to get it from Ken here.
James is pulling it up here. But I remember both of them pretty much back-to-back before the bye week.
We got the Raiders week one. Got the Redskins, the Washington Commanders week two. Miami Dolphins week three. Bears week four. Jets week five. And I won't bore everybody else with the rest of the
schedule. Well, no, that's where it goes. Chiefs. Green Bay Chiefs bye week. Yeah. Chiefs, yes. Green Bay Chiefs. That is going to be.
It is. So it goes Bears, Jets, Chiefs, Green Bay Chiefs bye week, which is the bye week's right dead in the middle. Then we go back to Buffalo in Buffalo.
hey, it's better than when we have Chiefs right before bye week and then Chiefs right after bye week.
I mean, if we go 500 to the Chiefs game and we lose both those games to the Chiefs, we still got a chance.
We can still pull it back.
Second half of the season is pretty soft, so we can see what up. We got the Bills, Vikings, Browns, Texans, Chargers, Lions, Patriots, Chargers, Raiders to end the year. Begin the year with the Raiders, end the year with the Raiders. I like them odds. I'll take that every time.
To go along with the NBA five-pack of games on Christmas Day, the NFL is going to do three games on Christmas Day.
Are they?
Yes. We are getting the Raiders and the Chiefs to kick off the day.
Mm-hmm.
Not bad. Followed by the Giants and the Eagles. And closing it out with the Ravens and the Niners.
Oh.
On Christmas Day.
Nice. Two favorite teams together playing against each other?
Yes.
For real. Suppose,
I guess
so. On Christmas Day. Nice.
I
gotta
watch that game. Mm-hmm. I will not be cooking at that point.
No cooking on Christmas Day.
Huh? No, it starts at like 6, no, so dinner will be done. Mom,
but I will not be cooking and cleaning during that game.
Okay. 6:20 Eastern. Christmas night on NBC.
And a quick shout out to the Mammoth. They are also in playoffs.
Oh, yeah, Mammoth.
There we go. Right now. They should be playing right now.
Entertainment news, we got. Nobody cares about Fast. Is that Fast
X? Fast X.
Talk about Fast X.
Fast X.
Listen, Ken, that has nothing to do with Coins, Cars, or Comics.
Hey, I got some fucking.
It's about family.
It's all these cars.
Delicious news of the right now. For those of you who followed the series The Great, starring Nicholas Holt, who also played in Renfield. That comes out tonight. Season 3, tonight. They're dumping the whole damn thing at 10 o'clock. The cliffhanger was just anybody who follows that show, you know the cliffhanger was just crazy, crazy stuff.
When do you watch this show?
When don't I watch this show? I watch this show when I'm getting ready in the morning. I've rewatched this series, The Great, like four times over, seasons 1 and 2. It's like one of the best shows out there ever. Anytime I'm feeling down, I always watch this show and it makes me feel so much better because the Russian Empire sucked ass. It was so bad that it makes me feel good about life. And it's super funny and raunchy. It's like every kind of... Nicholas Holt is just such a horrible, horrible human being in it. And it's fantastic the way that he goes about life.
What else is fantastic? Currently, Beavis and Butthead news episodes every Thursday.
Every Thursday. That's also pretty amazing. The last episode we watched, they just get stupider and stupider, and it's delightful to watch. Again, one of those things when your life is shit, you just go and, not saying that life is shit, but if you're having a bad day, a bad week, whatever.
When's the new season of The
Boys? You could go watch that, and it just makes everything better.
When the hell is the new season of The Boys coming out? Or any of these shows are waiting?
August.
You're not going to get them.
Invincible.
I thought it was
okay,
August.
No, everybody, let's just pause for a minute. If you guys want to talk about the real news, anything you thought you knew, you don't.
Oh, strike.
The Writers Guild of America is on strike, and it is bad, people. Last time this lasted 6 to 9 months, we were talking it could last over a year now. Let me take this to another level. Writers Guild is on strike. Next month, the Actors Guild, SAG, is renegotiating and looks like they're going to go on strike. 2 weeks later, DAGA, the Directors Guild of America, is also looking to go on strike. Hollywood itself is going to come to a shutdown worse than it did in 2007. So any show you thought was coming out next year, don't put any
guests on. What do they have to bitch about? What? Not enough good food on the food trucks?
Let me throw out a couple of things.
Not enough parties in the Piper Room.
Not enough parties in the Piper Room.
On the writer's end, here are the three big things the writers complain about. Writers are paid by the episode, and all of these series have been cutting from old 24 episodes was what it used to be to 12 to 16. So the writers are actively getting paid
or eight.
Less.
Yeah.
The second part of this is writers
on these other series like Netflix, Amazon.
Writers don't get series. So everybody else, directors and actors and producers, they get a small portion every time the episode is reshown. Writers don't get that. They get a one-time fee. So they're asking for a little portion every time it's reshown. But then this is the last thing. And this coming from the writers, I absolutely understand. It's going to be something you hear a lot more about over the next few years. They asked, one of their big asking points was asking the studios to not allow AI to write episodes. The studios came back with, no, let's see how good AI is next year.
You know South who started Park that? South Park, the good job, Trey Park and Matt Stone.
There you go.
They wrote a whole episode with AI.
Yes, they did.
Well, here's a fun fact, though. They already did wrap up filming season 4. So it's already ready to go. So they just have to release it.
So it all comes down, though, to the director. So if all these other people go on strike, this could be, it needs editors. It needs all these people to release. So some of these things that are already wrapped up, they might release on schedule. Anything that was in the middle of filming, anything that was in the middle of writing, anything that was in the middle of editing is going to have an issue.
Yeah.
So there's going to be a lot of issues going on as we move forward into Hollywood with this, which means you're going to see a lot more reality TV, just like you saw in 2007, kind of bringing us all the way back around to where we were talking with on Netflix now is The Golden Era. It is a story about Golden Auction House. Yes. And big part of the story is that
Ken Golden, his dad started scoreboard autographs. He got busted and kicked out of the industry about 35 years ago. Then,
man, guys, and up so, on Netflix now.
So well, we've been watching the Golden Show about Golden Auctions on Netflix.
The Triple LeBron logo man.
A lot
on
of
there.
Cool information on there. A lot of celebrities on there. Drake and others.
Well, I'll tell you guys this really quick before I forget.
Hold up. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah.
You'll only get reality TV from all that stuff because MTV, done.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, anyways, Bill's going to be on there.
Bill's is going to be on there on episode 5, I believe. So
it's already been on.
Denver, Colorado, it's on there. All episodes are downloaded. I haven't gotten that far in it, but props to Darren and Bill's. They did a great job on The Golden Show with Peyton friggin' Manning on there.
Yep. There are two things I want to say. Golden, also the people who held the record on the Illustrator Pikachu in between the Logan Paul Charizard and the Logan Paul Illustrator Pikachu. They had the record for about 2 months, and Logan Paul beat them again with somebody else. They talk about that a little bit on there. The other thing that was interesting on there, and I just want to throw this out before anybody sees it in the first episode and gets their hope up. The lady that they brought on to analyze the Beanie Babies
is in the
Beanie Babies documentary as being the lady who inflates the prices for her own gain.
She's so full of shit. Is that what's going on in that?
And
Trish and I were watching this. She's so full of shit. She buying any Beanie Babies?
Uh-huh. No, she has a bunch and she tries to inflate them for that price.
Okay, I wonder.
There is another expert on the Beanie Baby documentary who actually calls her out.
Don't call me with your Beanie Babies. They still are shit.
I honestly bet, if anything, if you guys watch that episode, what they did is something 8,000 is what the Beanie Babies question was. For everything else the guy had, they just gave him $9,000 and they sat on the Beanie Babies. They would have paid $9,000 for that in with that guy. But if you guys watch on HBO, there is a Beanie Baby documentary. If you go back and watch that after watching the Golden documentary, you will find that lady is on that documentary. And the current Beanie Baby experts all call her out for being some lady who tries to inflate the prices for her own gain.
Chris is not raising his hand. He's playing with the bottle back there, buddy.
You know, and I hate even saying this, but she looks like the type of lady that would be all into Beanie Babies. I'm just saying, that's like the stereotypical
look. Two into Beanie Babies.
Kurt Bishop, you were also right. Mm-hmm. Pez Outlaw, an amazing documentary. If you're looking for new content right now for collectibles, the Beanie Baby documentary on HBO Max, Pez Outlaw on Netflix, and the Golden.
Yeah, Pez Outlaw's good. Yep, good stuff. Gold, watch the Golden Company, though. It's really modern and what we're dealing with collectibles right now. The Macintosh and the Apple computers are really cool. Guy had sealed Apple One, Apple Two, Apple Three, right? Amazing. Trish, and sealed in box.
Also had this guy who had a Pokemon collection, including the original three Pikachu championship cards. Cool. Great find.
Very cool shit. I mean, it's high-end collectibles. Mile High Card Company is our sponsor. His competition is Golden.
I was going to say, constantly are like,
those are the three big guys in the industry.
Yeah, he constantly is like, if we don't get it, our competitors can get it. When he says our competitors, he means Mile High Auction House and Heritage Auction House. That is the three.
Ken has a great quote in this, and I know Ken Golden. I've seen him at seminars. Trish and I go to these top seminars or summits. Ken Golden's there. But his quote in this show was, three things feed him to make him go in this hobby, because he's the hobby king, he calls himself, the collectibles hobby king. Ego, competition, and money. Is that what it was? Mm-hmm. Maybe not that order. Competition, ego, and money is what drives him.
And I said that after this life, he'll be going promptly to hell.
Yes. So I think those are the three things that probably get you into hell first. I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, in I've gotten as far as it is funny seeing him have to deal with some. I've gotten as far as the episode where he flies out to Puerto Rico. You get there?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So he flies out to Puerto Rico. This guy in Puerto Rico has one of the largest collections of like individual signed autographs and everything ever. And man, this guy just works. And it's fucking hilarious.
The guy's story is cool. The guy with all the soccer memorabilia really is really fun. Cool. Self-made millionaire by buying soccer memorabilia before everybody else in Europe. I mean, it was easy to access.
Babe, I think that's the one you thought was the Puerto Rican one. We haven't seen the signature one.
So that was, I think you guys are one episode away.
We saw the hair one. The guy saw Mr.
Yeah, presidential.
You saw the hair?
I did see the hair. But did you see our boy, Ric Flair?
No, we didn't get that one.
You're an episode off.
Yeah. Flair. Everybody was like, woo,
and he yells at him. He's like, that wasn't enough. And he woos again and makes them all woo.
I think you were snoring through that.
I might have.
Yeah, it comes in to verify one of his robes. If I'm not wrong, one of the robes they tried to get on the WWE collector show is the one
butterfly one.
Okay, the butterfly?
Maybe not. It's the red crown robe that they go for on this one.
I'm looking for a Ric Flair robe. If anyone's got one for sale, bring it to all scenes. I'm like buying wrestling memorabilia all the time. Looking for any
Ric Flair robe,
especially right Matt Warren used wrestling men.
Half-eaten Ric Flair wing.
I'll take the George Animal Steel half-eaten ring post, buddy. How about that? What you know about George?
Nothing.
Jason King, we have not gotten the blade yet. He was due out within the next couple weeks, but we will get him. I got him on order.
Thanks for watching, Jason. Thanks for being with us. Omar, thanks, Haas, for being with us. Austin Kearns, thank you, guys. Thank you all for coming to Free Comic Book Day, being a part of this podcast with us. Kurt, Zavon, thank you, sir.
He's asking, how was it for the store?
Oh, it's great. Free Comic Book Day is always great. We're getting comic books into new readers' hands, and that's what's great about it. If I look at the pictures on social media, I see kids I haven't seen in the store before coming for the first time and getting their first comic book maybe ever. Well, I think it's very cool, and that's really what shines my heart about the whole thing. When we were at the Capitol, Tom Sullivan, State Senator Tom Sullivan, my good friend, I've known him since I was a kid, had a great speech, and he brought me to tears. He was saying how this place gets you away. Comic books get you away from the troubles in life, things you go through in life sometimes. And that's also a great reason why we want to push Free Comic Book Day. It's an exit from reality sometimes to a place where it's better. Or not necessarily. A lot of comic book universes are drama filled, but it's not this universe.
It's something you can lean in
and relax on. You know what I mean? So,
and I want to throw this out there. Another going on to the gaming side, we had a bunch of these magic welcome boosters we've been stocking up. We handed out the majority. I think I only have like a small fraction left after Free Comic Day. And that led to an immediate influx. I had guys coming on Sunday. I sold all these new guys, commander decks. We have people getting into the hobby, getting in the game. That's what this is all about. We are all here to try to get you guys into this. And it's not just because, you know, we like these things and we want you to collect them. It's fun. These things are a good thing to break you out of reality, play a game, read a comic, enjoy yourself. That's what life is about.
Exactly. That's what Free Comic Book Day is about. Let's go. Kurt, thank you for being third in line. I bet you had a blast hanging out with Juliet and her mom. You can't beat them. Every year they beat you. They're 1-2. You got here early. I surprised the first four people with donuts when I got here.
And free toys.
And free toys. But they're first four. I had Winchell's in my hand. I'm like, y'all get a donut.
You guys get
donuts. First pick on donuts because you're here first.
I was 1 second. I was worried because about 9 o'clock that line was not as deep as it normally was. And man, all of a sudden 9:45 rolls around and it is around the side of the building like always.
Vultures swooping in. Caca.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It was a ton of fun. I got to say thank you to everybody coming out. I want to personally thank everybody who signed the Aurora Rise license plate. I got like 50 signatures that day that we got to upload. Huge day for the Aurora Rise thing. If you guys haven't yet, check out aurorarise.com/we rise. Sign that license plate petition. We are pushing it as fast as we can here. I got some goals for 720 this year. Also, we are going to be posting any moment now. I'm getting the last of the stuff updated on Facebook there, and we're going to have that scholarship application going. If you guys have anyone under 18 looking to apply for scholarships, go ahead and check that out.
Great chance for any Colorado student, right?
Not absolutely. Just Aurora. Anywhere in Colorado, you guys have a chance to get it. Students under 18 or 18 or under, so it's a chance it could be used for your first year in college. It can be used to get books next year. Last year, we used it to help send a kid to band camp because they weren't able to afford it. Oh, there is so many options here.
You know what happens in band camp?
Hey.
Wow.
All kinds of things happen in band camp.
Jeez. Yeah, that's awesome. Great work by Aurora Rise. Great job, AJ, Chris, and everybody else part of Aurora Rise. And our state senate, again, thank
absolutely.
You.
And Jason King was like just saying, evidently, he's finding out like people are selling Free Comic Book Day books.
Yeah, that's been a thing for a while. Yeah, Umbrella Academy back in the day was worth some money on Free Comic Book
Day. Like five or six of them were worth like $10.
Jason, is if weird. You hadn't tuned in yet, you're probably thinking about the Spider-Man 2 one. We already talked about it. It was a shock to everybody. We didn't even get any copies. They threw it in last minute. It was completely missed. The odd one, I just want to throw this out. The one that sold, or not sold, was given away first here. And I had people all day asking about RuneScape.
Really?
RuneScape, oh, yeah, the game right. from back in 2000. People we got like 10 copies of, didn't think anybody would want. And boom, it was the hot book of the day.
What you know about those runes?
I ran out of Smurfs.
It's not runes, man. It's like, this is like the first WoW-style MMO. Yeah. AJ used to be playing this in sixth grade.
Oh, okay, cool. Zayvon, I did see your question, sorry. Trish is not in her normal spot because she was working. She didn't think she'd be able to make the podcast. We are all very pleased that she did.
Hey, AJ, would Pac-Ham be a Dark Raven or a Space Wolf? Now, the Pac-Man here is a Space Wolf. If you've ever seen the Space Wolf, Pac-Man is riding in with a big-ass Dire Wolf and taking your ass down.
Here's a good one for Free Comic Book Day. Zavon asked me who the best Batman in theatrical movie release was. My answer, Adam West, of course, was number one. Gave Zavon an 8x10 photo color for asking me the awesome question. Adam West is still the answer to that question. Ooh. The only one that carries shark repellent would be Adam West.
I'm going to, you know.
Best theatrical performance of Batman.
Does theatrical include animated? Because I might go Kevin Conroy.
Batman. I mean, that guy lived that shit.
He did.
Adam West thought he was Batman.
The Bat-Toosie? You talk about the Bat-Toosie?
I still don't put Adam West number one, man.
Adam West number one, and Kevin Conroy right up there with me.
Yeah, sure, okay.
I'd say theatrical of just Batman portrayals, it's Michael Keaton. Mm. But overall, Batman and Bruce Wayne.
I never saw
Batman and Bruce Wayne. Hold on. It's Christian Bale.
I never saw Adam West doing any poses like this.
Chris, let's get to the flash movie before we say anything about Michael Keaton.
Adam West whooped ass so hard, people. Word bubbles came out their face.
I know. Pow, I understand. Wham,
coming out their mouth when he hit him.
There's the describe how hard you got hit.
Yeah. Have you ever seen that kind of shit?
Hey, no. I understand. I don't know as far as actual portrayal of
that's what happens when I get in a fight, and that's why I don't fight.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Zavon, the fact that you said Arkham Batman, and you didn't even give us the name of the actor. Well, I'm disappointed in you, man. Yeah, that's not even theatrical. That's a video game. I am going to be the first one. And I was about to say, the reason is that is the same guy I just said. Come on, Zavon. You just agreeing with AJ over. It is. They use Mark Hamill and Kevin Conroy. I'm just saying, Zavon's agreeing with me and doesn't even realize it.
I knew Mark Hamill was. That's awesome, Z. Thank you for watching.
The last Joker performance.
Yeah, that's the point, Zavon. You're just agreeing with me over here.
He did the two Arkham games, and then he retired.
I never thought it would get worse.
Fuck yeah. Let's go.
All right.
I'm still going Adam West, by the way. Adam fucking West.
Hey. No, nobody's saying shiny favorite, Robert Pattinson.
Who's your favorite Batman?
There's only one Batman.
Who's that?
It's Michael Keaton.
Ooh, there you go. Okay.
I thought you were gonna go Batfleck.
No way.
No Batfleck. No, no Robert Pattinson. No Christian Bale.
I never even bothered to watch Robert Pattinson as Batman. I couldn't do it.
That was my first Batman. Michael
Keaton? Guys,
huh? And you said Kevin Conroy.
There was only one Bat Nipples though. And that's George Clooney.
Oh, yeah.
We don't talk about Clooney.
It's true Clooney. Alicia Silverstone.
Second is Lego Batman.
Hey, James.
Lego Batman was awesome.
What show would get higher ratings or higher rating Pac-Man starring, The Love Boat or Pac-Man on Fantasy Island?
Ooh, wait.
I'm going Pac-Man on Love Boat.
Really? Over Fantasy Island?
No, I am. He needs to be on Love Boat.
Yeah.
Pac-Man needs to find love.
Fantasy Island is way too psychedelic for Chris, but Love Boat for sure. Fantasy Island's trippy, scary, drinking, partying.
Zavon.
In and up of beds, weird people and shit. Fantasy Island's crazy.
Zavon is saying there's a difference between the animated series and the Arkham Kevin Conroy. Either way, it's fucking Kevin Conroy. The argument is it's Kevin Conroy.
Right. We're going for
go
the
fuck
actor.
Off, C.
We're going for the actor. We're going for the actor.
But you know what? If you go for like Batman per se, as far as in media, one of the best Batman was actually a cartoon. But the whole thing in general was really good. But the Batman was really good. And that was the Batman cartoon.
It's true.
That was weird because it had dreadlock barefoot Joker. And Edge from U2 fame did the soundtrack. But as far as an actual Batman portrayal of dark, creepy, what you think he would be like, I think that portrayal adaptation of him was really good.
Zavon
second thinks... for Christian Bale. I like Christian Bale, but
I like Christian Bale.
Till in the third Batman where they made him fucking quit and he just leaves with Catwoman and quits being Batman.
I'm saying
that never happened Batman. In the goddamn
I have movie. To ignore the
or
third
anywhere
movie.
Anywhere Batman stories ever but took place, did
Christian
he fucking
Bale
quit
was the best at both.
Other than those movies.
He was the best mixture of Bruce Wayne and Batman. Yes.
I would rather Batman die in a helicopter explosion and not know what the fuck's going on.
Do you want the original comic book death? Where his helicopter blew up and he fell into Gotham Harbor and then just disappeared?
Yes, that's better than him fucking quitting. Yeah.
Before, like, 2 months later, he got hit with the Omega beams and that was supposedly what killed him?
More realistic. Have King Shark eat his ass. I don't know. That's more realistic. You know who that wouldn't happen to? Adam West is Batman because he got that shark repellent. Okay. Have so you that's seen, why he's a badass. Again.
In one of the more recent comics, a bunch of the Batmans from different universes are crossing over. and current Batman like runs into Adam West Batman and he gives him shark repellent. And he has this whole line where he's like, I thought I was the most prepared Batman in the multiverse. I was wrong. Adam West is the most prepared Batman in the multiverse.
If you look at how he solves every crime, he never fucking loses.
No,
they literally just running the whole city. The mayor don't know what to do. The commissioner don't know what to do. He's got to get that little William Shakespeare fucking head. Hit the
Chief button. O'Hara was an idiot.
Chief
moron. He made Schultz. He made Schultz from Hogan's Heroes look smart.
Hey, it's in that universe's canon now. I heard in the comic universe.
Sounds like Charles is gonna take some time off and be on Love Boat with you.
Charles going
around. Charles,
love it. Charles is still alive.
She still looks like Charo.
She does.
I saw her somewhere. Chris wishes he could get with Charo. She'd be like, "Yeah, yeah, Chris.
That woman is scary looking. Why would you want to? Yeah, she's all inflated. Yeah. None of it's real."
Hey, they're thinking 30 years ago, Charo.
Think of Love Boat Charo.
I'm still thinking.
I thought he was talking about Lego Charo.
Well, no. She was on the Love Boat. She had to float away.
I was going to say, yes, nope. She would be a flotation device.
I love how AJ's mom had everything on VHS, so he knows all of this shit. He knows
who Grandma recorded all this shit on VHS. We had this entire fold-out cabinet. Each one had 3 hours of recordings. I'm saying, I might have been born in the 80s, but I know all about the 70s.
Joni loves Chachi, all that
Joni
shit.
Joni loves Chachi.
Oh, yeah, that one.
Let's go.
I only think of that when they were saying, Joni loves Chachi.
Joni loves Chachi.
Did you all know that?
Dashball. I'm sorry.
You're getting me here. Okay, did you guys know the Fonz was the original person asked to be Danny in Grease? And he turned down the role because he didn't want to be typecast. And then he later had this whole thing where he was like, man, but fucking John Travolta bought a fucking jet with that movie, and I just should have.
Well, then he typecast as the Fonz who fucking jumps the shark and fucks up his whole career.
It wasn't until Adam Sandler brought him back in things that people remember the something other than Fonz. Yeah.
Little Mickey, right. Where he gets stung with bees.
You have a water
place. Cover Henry Winkler with bees.
He's a fucking dumb coach that's all depressed.
Oh, Henry Winkler.
Yep.
Oh,
he's basically made fun of in every movie.
You gotta read this.
Can you imagine Henry Winkler doing Saturday Night Live?
One more question from Kurt, and then we're gonna wrap this thing up with Con News. Is that where we're at?
Yep.
Here?
Yep.
All right. Hey James, what show would Packham be the better villain in? Dallas or Falcon Crest? Here's my answer. Neither of the above. I'm going with Walker, Texas Ranger.
I was going to say Yellowstone.
I'm going to go either one. He could go Dallas and be an oil tycoon, but if we go bucket hat on Chris, you'd be like, hey, y'all.
I compete with JR, though, man.
Boss Hoss.
Yeah. You can take Boss Hoss and a big Cadillac. I can see it.
Falcon Crest, which brings up the question, how many people even remember Falcon Crest besides me and Kurt? Your boy Lorenzo Lamas was on.
I don't know. I'm gone.
Yeah. It was like the Napa Valley Dallas. They were like a wine family instead of oil barons.
We're not talking about Beetlejuice news. That's not happening.
I don't believe in the Beetlejuice.
There's a second Beetlejuice movie. Jenna Ortega's in it.
I don't know if that's Michael real. That's just what
it's real. Movies. Jenna Ortega's in it. They're filming. I've seen the shit.
That's the same.
That was a writer.
The big difference is
you just said there's no movies.
No writers.
It's over. Writers strike.
Not right now.
It's all over. Striking.
So no, come back to what we just said. The writer strike's over. Script is done. They're in the middle of filming. Now, if the actors in 2 weeks go to fucking strike.
Beetlejuice time.
But right now, the big news is that Jenna Ortega, the girl who played Wednesday, has been cast and is actively filming.
Oh, yeah. I saw
that. That's the big news.
I just don't believe it.
She's playing her daughter.
Lydia
is still being played by Winona Ryder.
Yeah. And she's still Lydia.
She will be her daughter.
Oh. I love all those actresses.
Now, so my question is, what are they going to do with Alec Baldwin?
Don't count on anything you're hearing. There might be no movies in the next fucking year.
I mean, Tim Burton ain't made a good movie since fucking Beetlejuice. So
he has.
What?
Lots of them.
What?
What do you mean?
From Hell.
Okay.
Give me one.
Sleepy Hollow.
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Sleepy Hollow is okay.
Sweeney Todd.
Nope.
Oh, God.
AJ,
damn it, AJ.
I'm getting mad at James over here.
Sweeney Todd's trash, dude. That isn't a good movie. Don't you put that on me.
Took out the music.
I will accept Mars Attacks.
Mars Attacks?
I got some for you. I got some.
That's it.
James don't like no Nightmare Before Christmas. Nope. James don't like no Corpse Bride.
Nope.
No.
Corpse Bride was amazing. How dare you?
Try hard bullshit. Just what? Like them. Yeah.
Here's where I'm going for you, James.
Caroline, Tim Burton, all the time.
Was horrible too.
I'll go fuck up Alice in Wonderland.
Caroline, come on.
You know he did fuck up Alice in Wonderland. I don't know how you can fuck up Alice in Wonderland.
Guys, listen. I'm going to go on a bit of a rant here with the Tim Burton. Now I already got it here. Alice in Wonderland, Tim Burton. James, all I got to say about that is you weren't on enough drugs. I saw that 3D in the theaters. I was out of my mind, and it was one of the best movies I've ever seen.
I didn't know it called now, for LSD.
I don't ever want
to
see it.
You don't have to.
It calls for a lot of things.
If you ever truly want to experience Alice in Wonderland, you have to be on LSD.
Well, at least mushrooms. Come on.
I'm good.
I saw that 3D in theaters really high, and let me tell you, it was fucking great.
I have far too many obligations. I'm like the white rabbit. I can't go doing that.
I had plenty of obligations too, but I found time to have some edibles and see some 3D.
Somehow you're the White Rabbit and the Mad Hatter all at once, sir.
And the chest.
And the queen, off with her head!
I'm a little bit of a sadist too, you know what I mean? But, you know, it's fine. Con news, kid, let's go.
Ken, what the fuck we got coming?
We got a lot coming. This weekend, there's a couple of shows. You're going to have the Rocky Mountain Horror Rocky Mountain Nightmare Festival and Film Festival. They're going to have something like 20 some guests there.
House of Thousand Corpses.
Ranging from House of Thousand Corpses. Serena Vincent's going to be there. One of the Jasons are going to be there.
Friday the 13th.
Yeah.
But it's at the fucking Hyatt Hotel. Yeah, how many Hyatt can you downtown. Squeeze in there?
I mean, we've squeezed a lot in there before.
Which Hyatt downtown? I'm not sure. I can't remember. But it is one of the Hyatts downtown. Then also there's the Otaku Attic, or some of our friends down over off running their anime shop over off of Koufax and Wadsworth is having their second year anniversary celebrating their shop, like a little anime mini con that's gonna be happening over off of basically near Clinton and Arapaho Road. So that's gonna be a lot of fun.
And then,
okay,
you know what I'm waiting for, Ken? Hit him with the big news
next weekend.
That's it,
next weekend. All Seas will be at two of the four shows happening next weekend. It's going to be...
There's four shows
happening? Hey, we're at the two biggest shows. We don't even care about the other four. Let's talk about them.
We do care because one of them is our friends.
Yeah, Mark shows iCards.
Okay, iCards, we care about. You just had a bad weekend.
Be happening. Free entry to get in over there off of Crown Plaza. It's going to be over at 6900 Tower Road at the Doubletree.
Yeah.
Go there,
location.
Check it out. A lot of great vendors, a lot of good stuff over there.
Amazing hotel.
Once you're
amazing
done checking food. That out, where should we go?
You're gonna make your stop over at the TCG Con Denver.
Woo!
That's going to be at the National Western Complex.
Huge show.
Tons of tournaments going on. Cash prizes.
I'm going to throw this out there.
Prizes.
We're buying. We're putting up a buying table.
AJ's going to be down there buying your stuff, so bring it in. You're going to have gaming TCG. You can buy that Kevin Eastman signed.
You want
Nintendo
that Kevin Eastman? I got that Kevin Eastman. Then you want some magic? I got some magic. You want Pokemon? I got Pokemon.
Then you're going to be able to see me and Trish right after that.
And James.
James might be piddling around. He
might be more
around.
TCG
color. Oh, I like him.
I'm going to be moving.
James is always moving. You know how he is.
That product you're buying. We're going to be buying so
he moving,
much.
He going, he moving.
He's going to have to come bring you more money.
Exactly.
He's be moving so much. Axel Foley. That will risk out.
You and Don.
Like the guy.
And because of this, now you're going to get attacked before you even get through the door.
Yeah, I have so much. No,
this is like, this is our Don, that guy in Golden, where he's like, have you ever killed someone before? I don't want to talk about it.
Yeah, well, that's where you're scared. That's a bad motherfucker right there. That guy's bad motherfucker.
You're going to see me and Trish primarily and Power Ranger Anthony. Over at Retromania down at the Arapahoe County Fairgrounds.
Oh, I got you some more help. Tim Vandry is going to be
Mr.
there.
Mr. Vandry. We're going to have our con guy Eric up at TCG Con. We got a crew. We have our con crew on staff.
People they know from this podcast.
And as always, stores will be open.
Stores,
all three locations.
All stores do not have to close.
All three locations will be open.
You know how we rock it every time.
Buying strong. If you want to see the beard, come by sell shit to the beard.
Beard beer.
Store. Morgan.
Damien B next door doing buying. Catherine, we got them all.
Yep.
Multiple tournaments going on at the store as well. So if you're not wanting to go play down at the TCG Con Denver for whatever reason or get knocked out, come on down.
I'm just saying, we got a big Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournament playing that Saturday night. We're going to be giving away the banner for the Power of Elements. We've got that old school banner from the last set going out for this one. Every time one of the banners rotates out, we put it in. Damien specifically wanted to wait till he was back from break. So you guys got TCG Con weekend to win that banner.
Right on, right on. All right.
And you got Battle Spirit Sagas over there.
Battle Spirit Saga rocking right now.
Yeah, we got, banners for that to give away both stores, too.
I just released
masks for it. Man, we are rocking in product right now.
If you're not following both the new event page and the new page for the All Seas Fan Expo, please go ahead and go do that.
Check out all our events, pages, all the time.
I just announced all our dates are released for next year, so there's no confusion on that from any other event or whatnot.
We're going to have 25 dates.
Yeah, we're going to have 25 dates here soon, too. But I just released our Garbage Island.
Farnsworth, my dear, love.
Hard at work.
She's killing it.
Always.
What was I doing?
Getting our dates. You were doing everything, Trisha. You are running everything behind the scenes, and you need some credit. Thank you.
Managing our money.
Thank you.
So, yeah, Garbage Island. We have only four more spots left that we're going to be filling with Garbage Pail Kids Scratch Card Artists.
I got a lot of garbage. Can I come?
Yeah, yeah. So Garbage Island will be led by Smokin' Joe, GBK artist, and then he'll be accompanied by several of the Garbage Pail Sketch Card Artists. I've even talked to Eddie. I designed the Gross Island logo. So that was just, I released that today and shared it all around.
Well, if you didn't see on Free Comic Book Day, Eddie gave out a free Heckler Garbage Pail Kid style card.
Yep.
We'll have a few of those left to give out at the show.
Those.
Eddie Rose, E3 Art, GPK artist.
But I'm thinking we do Garbage Island blanks, and then you'll be able to buy those blanks and get them get them commissioned by the artist there. I think it'd be a lot of fun for the attendees. Again, free admission.
Yep, and then we'll have Heckler product there. Heckler Comics by Jeffrey Peterson. The 420 comic will be there. I'm still looking for other celebrities. As always, comic talent.
Aurora Rise working on trying to land a couple right now. We'll see what we get.
Our first goal was Morgan Freeman, so we're going down.
Hey, Morgan. Listen, we started with Morgan Freeman. No. It was a little crazy. God has a high price. Yeah.
God's out, so we can't go with Morgan Freeman.
So if we can't get God, we're going to get you someone else. We're going down
from there.
Batman's cue.
You see how high we're starting?
That's all I can tell you.
We even got a note from him? That would
no, not really. No, it was price.
No. I looked at his price and I said no.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
We didn't know what the price.
Did you approximately have $750,000?
Are you serious?
I'm not joking.
Holy shit.
It's Morgan Freeman.
He's very popular. He's
the electric company. Some of the episodes of Through the Wormhole, too.
Yeah, I mean, this is...
I feel like he's an electric
company, right, Chris? We're seriously looking. We're getting some big names. Keep saying, too. We got a while.
You gotta have a lot of money out for that, though.
$100 an autograph.
Woo! Anyways.
$100 an autograph? No, like $100,000 an autograph.
Thanks for following, watching, being a part of this podcast. Thank you guys for watching. Keep at it. Latest.